this day is the day on which we launch a book that was written by an incredible author, and it is about the life and times of one of our heroes, the President of Congo, President Denis Sassou Nguesso. And this book launch, I have to say that it is one of its kind, and it is the first one. And the reason why I say so, it is because it is the first book launch that is done on a school level.
You're all welcome. I met Dr. Molemfo a few years ago. He came to school here in front. At the bottom you will see, I think you can still remember Ikanyang, Ach Ikanyeng, that was in matric last year. Do you? Yeah, nice girl. She wrote that poem when she was in the primary school, and it was published in one of these books. And in the third place, I said I'm your principal, I'm a history teacher, and I'm white.
And a woman,
thank you, sir. Some of them might disagree sometimes the way I act towards them. I can be very firm. But I'm also an African. I was born in this country. So when we speak about that, I had black friends long before 1994. I grew up with black people. I think all of you know that about me. I'm colorblind. And if we can get a whole country, the whole continent, the world, to recognize human beings instead of races, the problems will be solved. Dr. Molemfo is well known to me. I don't think one of you saw him maybe before, maybe when you were in my office, but he printed a lot of books already, published, if I'm not making a fault here. So he's actually a well-known author. So this is the launch of the book about the President of Congo Brazzaville. Also the people are here from that country. So please listen attentively, take things to heart, and go home. Be true to where you come from, and be willing to stand up for the right things so that we can bring about change.
The protocol of Brazzaville, on the banks of the Congo River, where leaders of three troubled nations who disputed each other were forced to sit down and sign a document that will forever change the history of the Southern Africa. The protocol of Brazzaville was one of peace. It was the protocol that washed away red blood between leaders. The protocol of justice and peace. It was a long, arduous process, but we can congratulate ourselves that it led to a successful signing of the Brazzaville Protocol on the 13th of December, 1988. It was a joyful day to many, a peaceful, long-awaited peace to the people of Africa. In many ways, the Protocol of Brazzaville was the new era of peace, the new era for Africa, and the new era of peace and glory to many. Thank you.
The Protocol of Brazzaville. 27 years now. Sadly, under the radar, it seems to be. Sadly, let's know. Let's talk and let's remember. Even the Battle of Kwaito Kanabani in Kuan Kubengu, January 13 to March 23, 1988, the second largest battle on African soil since the World War II, the Protocol of Brazzaville, peace imposed upon violence. Come out, Cuba. Come out of Angola. Come out, South Africa. Come out of Angola. We'll come out, say Cuba. Let South Africa relinquish its control over Namibia. The Cubans were fighting alongside of the Angolan government, UNITA, backed by the South African. South Africa withdrew, relinquishing its control over Namibia. Cuba withdrew. A ceasefire came upon and agreed the end of war in Angola. The Protocol of Brazzaville, among all, paved the way for independence in Namibia. The release of our president, Nelson Mandela, the president of Congo Brazzaville, Denis Sassou Nguesso, taking charge, opening the platform for the signing of the accord along the human Sambay Bay of the river of the River Congo, who also created the African Fund. We look at Africa and think war, think poverty, we think corruption, forgetting that we are the ones causing these things. We undermine Africa, forgetting that Africa does not need strong men, but strong men are built by Africa. A continent not of equality, but of equity. It does not give the same things, but give fairness in every situation. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Greetings to all the guests, students, educators, and the respected ambassador from Congo Brazzaville. He is the one and only Mr. Denis Nguesso. He was born in the Republic of Congo in 1943. He launched the Africa Fund in Brazzaville in 1986. In other words, he is an educator. He taught us that Africa is not just a continent. Africa is unique.
Oh, thank you so very much.
Thank you very much to the principal of the school. All I want to say, having heard, listened to the three poems and the very confident way that they were read, and what I see around me with the principal, if I had to go back to school, I wish I would come back here. Let me start with the author of the book, Dr. Molefo. He came to me, I think I was still a deputy minister then. By the way, the biography is not correct. I became a deputy minister in 96. And he had phoned my office and asked my office whether he could come and see me. So I saw him and he told me about this bright idea of his, about writing a book about Mbeki and then about others. And I was very impressed by his ideas. And I said to him, what do you want? And the only thing he wanted was that he should interview me about Mbeki. Well, that was the easy thing to do, which I did. And that was the start of him now producing something like 10 volumes with a very interesting approach of using a narrative of an uncle explaining some things and young people asking questions, but essentially written for young people, which I thought was a very important thing that needed to be done, because there's not enough material which could interest young people in wanting to find out not only about their own history. And now that you know your principal is a historian, you better get interested in history, but also about the history of our continent. Molefo himself, by the way, is a very good example of a migrant who's done very well. He came to this country, he didn't know a word of English. I don't know how he landed up here, but anyway, he found his way here. He didn't know a word of English. He went and studied English, and then went and studied and finished his PhD in English. So he himself is a very good example of what can be done, which Molefo brings out, is that President Nguesso, who was head of a one-party state for many years. And a one-party state meant, and by the way, when I was young, I supported a one-party state, but learned afterwards that that wasn't correct. And he then realized that for a democratic form of governance, so I want you to stand here and say, I am an African. Let's hear. Oh, no, no, what kind of children are you? Loud! I am an African.
I am an African.
Now I believe you, you are an African. Thank you very much.
Madam School Principal, Mrs. O'Neill, Honorable Minister Dr. Esop Ohad, Your Excellency Ambassador Edungwa of Equatorial Guinea, Dr. Mulenfu, distinguished members of the staff of Alliance High School, distinguished guests, dear learners. Let me start by thanking you all for organizing a ceremony and inviting the Embassy of Congo Brazzaville. I appreciate the fact that in spite of your busy schedule, you have made time and put efforts for this event, which is dedicated to my country and its president, to happen. This is very important to us, as it may well pave the way for a strong and mutually beneficial cooperation between your school and the Embassy of Congo. Allow me now to say a few words to the stars of the show today, that is, all the boys and girls who study in this school, that is you. Dear learners, I'm very happy to be among you. You helped me bring back memories of my youth, my childhood, that are very close to my heart. Some of you have been given the opportunity to read the story of Denis Sassou Nguesso, the President of the Republic of Congo, my country, in a book written by Dr. Mulenfu. They have learned about the President and the Congo by exchanging with Uncle Bongani, and they have tried to do their best to show their newly acquired knowledge. Knowledge is the key word. Study hard. You will rise and have access to all the tools that you need, not only to be successful in life, but mostly to play a positive part in society. You will learn that there are many examples of role models that you can undertake to follow. In order to achieve your goals, you must always listen to your teachers and your parents and uphold the values that they teach you. After the wise pieces of advice that were given to you by your Honorable Principal and Minister Pahad, I don't need to remind you that you are the future of your country, the leaders of tomorrow. One of the world's greatest leaders, Nelson Mandela, teaches that you have to believe in the talents that you have been given. Never be afraid to dream and have the tenacity to accomplish your dreams. This you can accomplish through education, one of the things that Tata Madiba cherished very deeply. I wish you a very bright future. Thank you very much.
To thank all of you for coming to this book launch to honor His Excellency President Denis Sassou Nguesso for his Pan-Africanist spirit and dedication to Africa. I thank you, Dr. Esop Ohad, for accepting the invitation to give the keynote address. at this book launch. And you reminded me all the years that I've been always coming to the presidency and bother you to give me information. And but I'm happy that you were always there for me and you supported me. And I hope that we shall continue to work together to make the African Renaissance a reality for our people throughout the African continent. To you, our children who are here and those who are not here, I also thank you for coming. And I wish you well in your studies as you begin to write your exams next week. I believe that you'll all pass. I sincerely hope that you'll develop the culture of reading books, but especially history books on Africa, because we don't have a lot of books written by Africans for African children. And that's my passion. I want to challenge our African leaders to invest more in education. And you should also read all other historical written materials for academic and leisure purposes. You need to remember that reading is knowledge and knowledge is power. Nobody will ever take that knowledge away from you until death. So reading is very important. Many thanks go to the principal of Elandspoort High School and her staff for accepting to organize this book launch at this school. In the process of continuing to honor President Denisa Sungesu as one of Africa's greatest humanists of the 20th century, but especially for his leadership and solidarity in the struggle against colonialism in Southern Africa, I pledge to collaborate with the school in the process of establishing Denisa Sungesu Leadership and Solidarity Institute. The school exchange program between Elandspoort High School and a high school in Brazzaville will be one among the first programs of the institute. I hope that this program will go off the ground in 2017. This program will also involve one high school in the Republic of Namibia. Before I conclude, I wish to use this opportunity to present to the Minister Councillor and Chargé d'Affaires at the Embassy of the Republic of Congo in South Africa a signed copy of the book by a few learners, some of the learners that you see here, for His Excellency Mr. Denis Sassou Nguesso, the President of the Republic of Congo.